Hello, welcome to the Natural History Museum. My name is Matt and I'm here with Tom, head of our gardens here. And we've been learning and talking about leaves, specifically why they turn orange. If you haven't seen that video, then please do check it out. But Tom, we've all seen a leaf, but what actually is a leaf?
Well, it's a good question. Leaves come in all sorts of different shapes, sizes, and come on all different types of plants. But generally, a leaf is a flat structure that can capture the light of the sun and use the sun's energy with chlorophyll to make food for the plant. So you generally find that your typical leaf shape might be something like this, you know, very round. I think we've all seen trees with leaves like this. But honestly, there's an infinite variety in different lifestyles and types of plants and how they use their leaves.
Oh, awesome. So my understanding was that leaves produce food for the plant.
Yeah.
But in the video we were just talking about, we've learned that some trees lose their leaves. Yeah. Why would any plant want to lose its leaf?
Yeah, well, plants put a lot of resource into making their leaves. So they have the chlorophyll from the photosynthesis. And, you know, there's lots of proteins and, you know, some of that's valuable to the plant. And if they live in an environment that might be a bit stressful, then it's beneficial to maybe save some of that resource and take it back. So they take back in that resource and they drop that leaf and then they put out a fresh new leaf in the spring. Certainly in the northern hemisphere temperate climates. But you also find deciduous trees and shrubs and that the life strategy in other parts of the globe. So you get dry deciduous forests in places like Madagascar or even the Mediterranean. There's a cool euphorbia species, euphorbia dendroides, a tree spurge that I've seen growing in Menorca and also Italy. And that drops its leaves in summer. So when it gets really hot and dry, it goes bright orange and then drops its leaves. And then in the autumn, when it gets some rain, it comes back. So it's a response to stress and a way of kind of keeping those resources with the plant.
Oh, very cool. So here in the UK, we're quite used to trees losing their leaves in winter, but not every tree does this. I mean, some stay green all year round.
No, absolutely. And some, you know, like I just said, you know, the plant puts resources into making these leaves. So for some, they decide, okay, you know what, we're going to make our leaves tough and leathery, and I'm going to make it so nothing wants to eat me. And, you know, our leaves are going to last a long time. So things like holly, which is the one I held up earlier, we've got a specimen behind us. Holly leaves are, you know, they're really quite tough and rubbery and leathery, and they last a long time. So these are called evergreens. Mm-hmm. Other common evergreen species you might get, conifers or gymnosperms, things like this Cryptomeria japonica or sugi. They have very tough needle-like leaves. They also contain lots of resins and things so that they discourage animals from eating them. So these are designed to last a long time and stay with the plant.
So just looking at these, all of these are leaves?
Yeah, they're a modified leaf. It's just like a scale-like leaf. But this would be another example. So this is Mahonia. And if you feel that, you can feel that it's quite prickly, so that's trying to discourage things from eating it. They're also really leathery. So it's a different way that plants adapt to their surroundings. So some will decide, okay, we're going to be evergreen. Some decide, you know what, let's go into dormancy for the winter and then go as a bare stem, save our water, save our resources, and then in the spring, let's start again and make a fresh new set of leaves.
Oh, so talking about those adaptations, are different colours useful? Why are leaves different colours?
So leaves are predominantly green. We see them as green because the chlorophyll in the leaf takes in the blue and red spectrums of light and it reflects the green. And that chlorophyll kind of dominates, and so we don't see the other pigments underneath. The yellow leaves, the yellow comes from carotenoids, I believe. And the carotenoids, I believe, are in the leaf all the time, but you just don't see them because it's masked by the chlorophyll and the green. So as soon as the chlorophyll starts to break down, then you start to see the yellow underneath. And actually that's why in some leaves, so the holly that we have behind us is variegated. So this has green and yellow splotches, and you might see lots of ornamental plants have variegated leaves. Mm-hmm. And that's something we've selected for because we find it attractive and often, mm-hmm. but it's often got, you know, patches with more chlorophyll and then some without. And so that's why you see it as yellow and green. And then the red colors, these come from anthocyanins, and some plants produce these in autumn and others contain them as well. And some plants in shady places might be a bit have a reddish tinge. This fritinia, you can see this is an evergreen leaf, but it's still got some tinges which are red. And so quite why those are red, I'm not exactly sure why fritinia has red petioles, but for some reason it's useful to the plant.
Well, that is absolutely fascinating. Who knew leaves could be so interesting? But I'm afraid we've run out of time. I could speak to you all day, but I think it's time for us to leave. I had a great time making that video with Tom. If you enjoyed it, then we release a new Surprising Science video every 2 weeks. So make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss it.